Hello friends. In my Telegram channel, I have repeatedly written about various options for external screens and monitors needed for tasks such as installing operating systems, troubleshooting, and outputting control consoles, among others. Here, I am referring to servers for managing smart homes, based on mini and single board PCs, although, of course, the use of such screens is not limited to this. Depending on the tasks, devices with touch screens, responsive to touch, are convenient for creating control consoles and regular screens, for temporary work or for displaying images from surveillance cameras. A key advantage of portable monitors is certainly their size and lightness, which allow them to be easily transported and used in places with limited space, and also powered via a standard USB port, which, combined with low power consumption, allows the use of even ordinary power banks. I decided to personally test one of these monitors and share my observations with you. Before we begin, as usual, please like this video. It will help others interested in the topic of smart homes find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, portable monitor. Screen size, 11.6 inches. Resolution, 1366 by 768 pixels. Two USB Type-C, mini HDMI, audio output. Built-in speakers. Dimensions, 278 by 178 by 13 millimeters. Mounting, 75 by 75 millimeters. Power supply, USB-C. The monitor arrived in a cardboard box sealed in plastic, and from the moment of order to receipt, it took 11 days, an excellent indicator for AliExpress. The packaging is secure, with the device protected on all sides by shock-absorbent inserts, so you don't have to worry, it will arrive in one piece. At the bottom of the box, underneath the monitor, we found accessories to it. I'll now go into a bit more detail about them. Here is the complete set included: the monitor, a stand, cables, a power supply, a small manual, and a booklet. For connecting to a video signal source, an HDMI, mini HDMI cable is used. A USB-C cable is needed for powering the monitor itself. A standard power supply with a European plug and a single USB-C port. A foldable metal stand for the monitor. A separate booklet describes how to use the monitor with the stand, and interestingly, it pictures a different stand than the one included in the package. I couldn't understand at first why it was there. The manual includes diagrams for connecting the monitor. It's all quite simple, but it's important to note that not all devices can output an image through USB-C. HDMI is the only guaranteed connection. Almost the entire front area of the monitor, which measures 278 by 178 millimeters, is occupied by the screen. The bottom bezel is significantly thicker than the others. The stand allows for adjusting to a comfortable angle and can also use VESA mounting. Additionally, on the back, there are holes for the speakers. There is sound as well. On the left side, there are a power and back button, a push button regulator, and a 3.5 millimeters audio output. On the right side, there are mini HDMI, USB-C transmission 3.1, and another USB for power. Looking ahead, the monitor can be powered from any of these. When turned on, the input selection menu for the video signal source briefly appears on the screen. It is determined automatically by default. It can be manually activated by pressing the power button. The sound is certainly not hi-fi. All that can be said about it is that it exists. But do not forget about the audio jack, into which headphones or external speakers can be connected. Before we start, please like this video, as it helps it reach more people interested in smart home topics, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. The colors, compared to a regular monitor, are frankly dull and unexpressive, but for temporary connections or video surveillance, they are quite adequate. Pressing the side button brings up the image settings menu. Turning the regulator up and down scrolls through its options. To change a setting, press the button again on the selected item and then turn to set the desired values. There are two quick settings. Turning the regulator down activates the brightness settings. And turning it up adjusts the volume of the speakers. The consumption at maximum brightness and volume allows the monitor to easily operate from a power bank. I think the monitor is quite suitable for use with video recorders. Many of them have USB ports that can be used to power the screen. One of the purposes for which I got this monitor was for temporary use when installing systems on single board and mini PCs. For this, it works excellently. Even small text is readable well, the monitor doesn't take up much space and can be connected to a USB port on a computer, not requiring separate external power. As a control terminal for a smart home, I think a model with a touchscreen would be better suited, for which a mouse would still be needed. But this is a matter of personal preference. Considering that the monitor cost me just over $35 on sale, I believe the purchase was justified. In my tests, I often need an external screen, and using a 55-inch TV is not always convenient for this purpose. With this monitor, everything is much simpler and more convenient. That's all. If you like the video, I would appreciate your like. It helps promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find links to stores where you can buy such a monitor, as well as a touchscreen version. There are also links to my Telegram channel, a group for discussing smart home issues, and a Facebook page. Join us. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.